It's no news that health practitioners recommend that you visit your doctor for a full health checkup at least once every year. However, unsurprisingly, men do not take this as seriously as women. Most men would rather wait until they can't walk or they're bent over in pain before they contact a doctor. So instead of reiterating the importance of getting an annual checkup, which is super important, by the way, in no particular order, let's look at the 14 health symptoms that men should never ignore. Number 1. Mole changes. If you've noticed that your moles are looking different, that is, they're getting bigger, or have a border, or have changed in color, or start to itch, that is something you want to report as soon as possible. Now, this might be nothing to worry about, as moles can start to look different because of an increase in non-cancerous pigment cells. However, as with basically every other thing, it's better safe than sorry. In addition to moles, you also want to report other changes on your skin, like rough skin patches or a sore that has refused to heal. At least, let the possibility of skin cancer and any other deadly issue be canceled. Plus, wouldn't it be nice if that inconvenience could be taken care of? Keep watching to find out how difficulty in urinating could pose a serious health danger. Number 2. A lump in your testicles. I would have gone on to lump this. Get it? Lump? Because lump? Anyway, I would have gone on to lump this with the mole changes, but I do think this deserves a separate mention. Because for the love of whatever is important to you, if you notice any kind of lump on your testicles, immediately report that to your doctor. It bears saying that just 1 out of 25 lumps is actually cancerous, but you'll agree with me that it is better to get that possibility out of the way, especially considering that a lump in the testicles could be a sign of the existence of other conditions aside from testicular cancer. Number 3. Feelings of depression. Depression rate is higher among women. However, men are actually more likely to commit suicide than women, and that is probably due to the fact that men are less likely to seek help than women. Depression is a real sickness that needs to be attended to by a medical practitioner. So if you find that you've become less enthusiastic about the things you used to love, you do not want to meet up with your friends, and/or your general disposition is now typically down and under, please seek professional help. Do not try to get yourself out of the funk by abusing substances like alcohol and/or drugs. The best thing you can do for yourself if you're in this position is to seek professional help. Number 4. Bowel changes. When it comes to your bowels and its movements, one thing you want to be safe from is bowel cancer, officially called colorectal cancer. This is why colonoscopy is something that is recommended. It is meant to detect any changes in your bowels. However, because most men wouldn't go to the doctor when they're seemingly healthy, here's what I'll say. If you notice any changes in your bowel movements, be immediately concerned. These changes could be anything from frequent diarrhea to constipation to blood in your stool, pain in your stomach or poop passage, or just even bloating. Like I said about the previous symptoms, these are not only indicative of a kind of cancer. In fact, some of them could just be indicative of a dietary problem, and some lifestyle changes could get things working fine again. But you won't know if you don't find out. Number 5. Difficulties urinating. I would ask about the last time you had a prostate examination, but I think we both know the answer might not be favorable. However, something else we both know is that the prostate is a very important organ for a man, especially in his sex life. Knowing this, it is important to immediately report any difficulties you encounter when you urinate. I'm talking things like a burning sensation or pain when you pee. Finding it difficult to let the pee out or having to wake up every night very often to pee. These problems could be a result of an enlarged prostate pressing on the tube that moves urine from the bladder. And that enlarged prostate is usually a sign of a prostate disease, not excluding cancer. So if you notice any of the already mentioned issues when you pee, consult with your doctor. Weight loss might not be great, but sudden and rapid weight loss, not so much. Keep watching to find out. Number 6. Consistent coughing. A little bit of coughing here and there is usually nothing to be bothered about. Cough is also something that goes away pretty quickly, even without you taking any sort of medication. Unless, of course, the cough is indicative of something serious. So if you've been coughing constantly for up to 3 weeks, you want to check that out. It could just be a chest infection, which is easily treated, but it could also be something worse, like heart failure or lung cancer. Number 7, chest pain. Chest pain can be indicative of a number of things, whether or not it's paired with cough. That chest pain that you don't want to report could be warning you that something is not right with your lungs, or gastrointestinal area, or even your heart. In fact, most people that have had a cardiac arrest usually had warning signs in the form of chest pain, shortness of breath, and heart palpitations. Now, I'm not saying that chest pain is a precursor for cardiac arrest, but you want to be sure. Number 8, weight loss. Unless you are deliberately trying to lose weight, weight loss is usually not a good sign. Weight loss could be symptomatic of cancer or a thyroid issue, but it could also be indicative of a less serious issue like stress or a change in diet. However, reporting this to your doctor will help you pinpoint the problem and get the appropriate solution. Number 9, frequent heartburn. It is probably safe to say that most people have experienced some form of heartburn at one time. So heartburn is usually not much cause for alarm and would go without much trouble. Heartburn could come as a result of eating food that is overspiced, wearing really tight clothes, consuming alcohol, or overeating. And if this is the case, taking over-the-counter solutions like antacid should take care of your problem. You also have to make the appropriate lifestyle changes, of course. However, if you've been getting frequent heartburns, or you're currently experiencing one that has refused to go, even after taking antacid, you definitely want to check that out. And this is because if heartburn is not responding to quick treatment, it could be a result of gastroesophageal reflux disease, GERD. Other health issues that GERD could cause include ulcers of the esophagus, bleeding, inflammation, and even cancer. So make sure you report to your doctor if you've been having heartburn that keeps returning or hasn't been responding to treatment, you know, just to be safe. Number 10, excessive snoring. While snoring could be posing an annoyance to the person that has to hear it, and posing an embarrassment to the person that does the snoring, it could actually be doing worse than that. It could be affecting the snorer's health. Now, I'm not talking about the kind of snoring that doesn't really disturb anybody, and both you and whoever in bed can sleep through. I'm talking about the kind of snoring that could even wake you up from sleep. Snores that are heavy enough to wake the person snoring could be indicative of obstructive sleep apnea. Sleep apnea is a sleep disorder in which breathing stops and restarts repeatedly. And when this happens, it is difficult to have a good night's rest, and the sufferer could end up waking up tired. Other things that sleep apnea could cause include irregular heartbeat, high blood pressure, stroke, and a heart attack. And these could happen because someone didn't think their excessive snoring problem was problem enough to be checked out by a doctor. Number 11, eye problems. Vision problems are usually associated with old age. However, young people could also have a problem with their vision. It is recommended that you have a regular eye checkup. And by regular, we're looking at about once or twice a year. That said, if you really don't want to do that, the burden is on you to pay attention to your eyes. If you notice any irregularities with your eyes like inflammation, redness, itching, pain, discharge, or film over the eyes, or you notice irregularities with your vision like seeing a halo around light, having blurry vision, tunnel vision, or blind spots, you really need to go check out your eyes. Sometimes eye pain could just be a result of eye strain caused by spending an ungodly amount of time in front of screens. And at other times, it could be a result of glaucoma, which could lead to blindness that cannot be reversed. Eye issues could also be symptomatic of problems that are not particularly eye-based, including brain tumor, a stroke, or even deafness. So yeah, report any irregularities with your eyes immediately. Number 12, impotence. Most men will find it difficult to get and or keep an erection at some point in their lives, and that is usually not a problem. However, if it is something that's been happening, you want to get these checked out as soon as possible. There is no need repeating the intimacy and sexual issues that impotence poses for a man. Thankfully, the problem could be solved by just a couple of lifestyle changes, including losing some weight and exercising. Medication could also be prescribed if necessary. However, more than it posing a problem for intimacy and sexual experience, impotence could also be a sign of something more serious like high blood pressure, heart disease, or diabetes. So if you've been finding it difficult to get it up, immediately consult your doctor. Number 13, memory loss. Everybody forgets things, especially where they kept their phone or car keys. However, when you start forgetting more and more things and more frequently, you want to get that checked out. Memory loss could be indicative of a vitamin deficiency, depression, brain tumor, or Alzheimer's disease. And as with any medical health issue, early detection is important if you want to have a chance at survival. So make sure you report any unusual memory loss to your physician. Number 14, constant fatigue. If you're always feeling tired, even after having what should have been a good night's rest, you want to talk to your physician as quickly as possible. I've already mentioned that sleep apnea could make one wake up tired and even go through the day tired. But even aside from sleep apnea, constant fatigue could be indicative of some kinds of cancers and infections. It's normal to feel laggy when you've been working constantly and haven't had proper rest. But if you've been getting the rest you need, but did not feel refreshed when you wake up, that is something you want to look into. Something else that could be causing your constant tiredness is the inability to sleep when you want to. So if you haven't been able to sleep at night, you sleep but for not long enough, or you do sleep but wake up way too often during the night, you certainly want to consult a doctor. Generally, men die about 5 years earlier than women. And this could be attributed to the fact that men are generally not as willing to visit a physician as women. Most men prefer to take care of their own problems or allow the problems to take care of themselves. However, I do hope that this video has encouraged you to pay a visit to your doctor. Comment down below your thoughts, give this a like, share with your friends, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button and notification bell to keep you updated for more interesting facts, tips, and ideas from Smartville.